I can feel my body cause I pop a lot of molly. Yo! Listen, yeah? Can we talk about the Nike React Element 87? I think that's how you pronounce the name. This shoe came out of nowhere. And arguably, it may be shoe of the month. Some are arguing shoe of the year. I'm not gonna say I think this is shoe of the year, because there's a lot of the year left to go, and some of the releases that I've seen that people have leaked and things like that look crazy. But anyway, this shoe's stupid. The last time I made a video like this, yeah, and sorry, I'm using the handy cam. The last time I made a video like this was the Puma Thunder Spectra, and arguably that is the most popular video on my channel so far, with 3,000 plus views. For me, that's a lot of views. For big YouTubers, that might be rubbish, innit? It's rubbish, let's face it. But anyway, while you're here, the Nike React Element 87 looks flipping dope, yeah? Listen to this description. The Nike React Element 87 is a shoe that owes its geometric design data drawn from everyday athletes. Do you know what they did? Do you want to hear what they did? Work on the shoe began by pressure map testing individuals who walk heavily throughout the day. So that's if you're going to the corner shop, that's if you're gonna go and run errands, that's if you're gonna go and pick up the children, that's if you're gonna go and surprise wifey at work with a bunch of flowers, that's if you're gonna go and surprise hubby at work with a bunch of flowers. These maps show the points where feet experience the most fatigue from commuting, running errands, and other activities during the day. A la what I just said, yeah? Nike and me, we're in sync there. Designers then drilled holes into these spots on the running shoe soles and repeated the process with Nike React foam for added comfort. And if you don't know about Nike React technology, it is like a cloud. It's cloud-like. Let me change hands because my left arm is getting pretty tired. If you haven't tried Nike React, please do so. You can go and try the Vapor Street Flyknits. They're full of React. You can try the Nike Epic React. That was the shoe that essentially launched the technology. They are a lot more affordable than the Vapor Flyknit Streets. And I think there's another version of the Nike Epic React that is a cheaper version that should be about 110 or 110 or 115 pounds, but it's not Flyknit, so it won't fit like a sock. And I hope I'm still in the middle of the screen there. So just bear with me, because I'm not used to using these Gorilla Grip thingy bobs that these guys use in the vlogs. I mean, it just looks crazy, and I'm gonna put up some images on screen of how they've designed it and things like that. But it looks insane. And the crazy thing is, whilst you've got the Epic React foam or the React foam on the outsole, the upper is made up of this like hyperfused, translucent, just amazing goodness. Let's just call it that, amazing, hyperfused, translucent goodness. And I'm not looking in the camera. It looks amazing, and it looks like the perfect shoe for summer and autumn. And the crazy thing is, there's a bunch of colorways coming up. It's not the Undercover collaboration that's due to happen later this year. If I'm really honest, I don't give a damn about the collaboration. It's the shoe itself. People think it's a GR, it's not a GR. It's not a GR. The black one may not sell out as quick as the white one, but as from what I've seen and from the hype behind it, this is gonna be a limited GR. It sounds contradictory. How can you have a general release that's limited? Well, with enough hype, and that, think about it this way. This shoe is so popular and it hasn't come out yet, and it's the first model. Nike haven't anticipated how popular the shoe was gonna be. Because you think about the VaporMax when it dropped last year. That was the first time it dropped, and it pretty much sold out. But then it restocked and restocked and restocked, and now you can pretty much go anywhere and pick up a VaporMax. Now just imagine, for a second, just hear me out. Imagine the VaporMax that dropped last year when it came out the first time. Imagine they didn't restock it. That means no one would have the pure platinum or the white and red VaporMax. And don't forget the Comme des Garçons laceless version that dropped, sold out everywhere, and it hasn't restocked. So don't sleep on this. It's not a GR, it's going to be limited because it's the first drop. So think about it, it's the first drop. So Nike essentially are testing the market. They don't know how popular it's gonna be. So whatever the stock is now, that's the stock when it drops. And the fact that it seems like there's more demand than they anticipated, I'm anticipating it's going to be more demand than supply. I think these will sell out, and it's gonna feel like it was a limited release, but it may have been produced, or production numbers may have been cautious at best. But anyway, back to the shoe. After receiving the data on the shoe on the initial tests, they worked out sketches, says one of the designers. The whole process was really a back-to-back basics exercise that taught them new ways to make the shoe look and feel great while also harnessing the power of cutting-edge computation design, baby. This shoe looks dope. I'm all about the white and cream sale colorway. The black one, I've seen someone on Instagram with an early pair of the black ones, and I gotta say, on foot, they look crazy. The React Element 87 drops in the black and white colorway and the white sale white colorway on the 21st of June 2018 via the sneakers app and a number of select retailers for £135, 8 a.m. Greenwich Mean Time. It's gonna be limited, even though it's anticipated as a GR. The only reason I say it's limited is because so many people are gonna want it. But yeah, that's just a little discussion about this shoe that I think is gonna be shoe of the month personally. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Follow me at @caf_official_insta on Instagram. And yeah, holla at your boy. Peace.